Two popular brands of soda kept trying to outdo each other with the best ads to get you to drink their product.
And the Cola Wars even went into space. I'm here today with curator Valerie Neal, and we're taking a look at some space food. And Valerie, I'm curious, how did we get these very strange looking soft drink cans in our collection?
Well, Coca-Cola and Pepsi approached NASA about flying soft drinks in space in an early shuttle mission in the early 1980s. This was a time known as the Cola Wars, when Coke and Pepsi were very competitive with each other, each wanting to be the number one soft drink provider in the world. And what could be cooler than to be the first soft drink in space?
So why soft drinks?
Well, they thought that maybe the crews would like to have a greater variety in their beverage selection. Astronauts had always been accustomed to powdered drinks, and they thought that maybe they'd like to have a good all-American soft drink while they were in space. But there are problems with that.
Yeah, I can see they've got these bizarre tops on them.
Exactly. If you were to pop the top of a soft drink can in space, it would spew everywhere and make a big mess. Or even if you twisted the cap, it would float out of the bottle. So the companies put some time and effort into devising a special soft drink can for use in weightlessness. And Coke developed a device on top that you would actually put in your mouth and push the button, and it would squirt the soft drink into your mouth. And then Pepsi did an adaptation of a standard shaving cream can or a whipped cream can, where again, you would put the little spigot on top right into your mouth and drink that way. And just as shaving cream and whipped cream come out pretty foamy, so did Pepsi, and so did Coke for that matter. The crews were not really impressed with the taste or the mix of carbonation and syrup.
And is it in there just the way an ordinary Coke can or Pepsi can is?
No, there's actually structure inside the can to keep the carbonation and the syrup separate so that they would mix at the point of drinking. Okay. And they tried different combinations and they never got the taste quite right or the consistency quite right.
Well, how do you keep an ice cold soft drink in space?
Well, that was also part of the problem. There's no refrigerator on the space shuttle. Oh. And so they had to drink at room temperature. And who likes to drink a warm soft drink?
Not me.
Not the astronauts either.
Well, thank you very much. It's very interesting history on Cola Wars in space. Let us know what your favorite part of this video was in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. Also, you can follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and be sure to subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.